Okay, guys, well, it looks like the power supply hasn't failed. It is mildly warm. I've been basically using the server to serve up Plex for the last couple of days. And it works pretty smooth over the network. I'm thinking of ditching Windows, obviously. I'm going to run something a little more server-based. One thing I did notice with the power supply, though, is that the RPM of the fan looks a little slow. And the other day when I went to turn down, the computer off to do some changes to it, and I watched the fan stop on this power supply, it stops instantly, and that's never a good thing. So I explain why it's going so slow is because, like, more than likely that fan's about to fail. So what we're going to do is we're going to carefully pull it apart, obviously, because it's been powered up, and we're going to change out that fan. I have a box full of them, and see if that will get rid of that problem. I don't know what type of fan it is, if it monitors the speed on it, or if it just stays at one speed only. Whoop. So we're going to find out. Yeah, it's not even that hot. It should be able to handle more of the load. It was from a half decent computer before, so. Just have a quick look at the fan before we go grab another one. So, I've been looking online for a case, and I'm stuck either getting that server type case, which is good for like hard drives and everything else, or you can get just a normal case that has half decent hard drive trays in it. It's up in the air. I was even thinking about buying myself a nice gaming case for my home computer and using my case that I just got as a server case. Like I said, it's up in the air right now. Won't know until next week when I order it. Well, this is clean inside. Well, no bad capacitors from what I can see, or swelled up. That one even looks like it was replaced. I don't think I ever serviced this one. Or maybe I did. These do not look like OEM capacitors. I might have been in here already. Not a bad power supply. Could have been better on this chip right here. There's not much in the way of a pad or even the paste on it. But I'm not going to touch it. The fan, the fan is not that good. Let's pull it out and have a look at it. See, I'd rather just swap this out because I've had fans fail on the power supply in the past. And by the time you do notice the fan has failed, the damage is done, so. There's a big-ass spider on the floor. Look at the size of that sucker. No, don't get away. I don't want you crawling around here. Sorry, dude. Oh, you're crunchy. That's nasty. Alright. Cut that out of the video. Okay. So let's pull this fan out. Yeah, it's just single wire. I'm being very careful here. This is the high side is really what you have to worry about. This is the low side, so it should be alright. Just having a look at the plug here. It's a standard plug, but it doesn't have any. Doesn't look like it has any polarity on it, unless it's on the board. Let me have a look here. Nope. But it shows it's a 3-pin, but yet it's a 2. That's weird. I'm going to mark it only because I don't want to That blow up the new one when I put it in. There we go. Alright, it's out. It's a no-name piece of junk. It's seen better days. Sleep berry, dry as bone. Well, let's take you in the other room and see what I got. Alright, I do have a few. I don't know if you can see that. I don't know if I got one this size though. These are all bigger. Except for this one. It's definitely smoother. A little bit thicker. I'll leave that one out. That's about it. That's an oddball size. So we got this one here. Another no-name. Let's have a quick look at it, see if it's even worth... might just repack the one we have. Oh, this one is pretty nasty looking. Let's quickly take the sticker off. If it's another, if it's not sealed bearings, then I'm not going to waste my time with this one. We'll just repack the other one. This one might be sealed bearings. I could get into it. Oh my moly. Maybe one of those ones you can't take apart. Oh, Jesus. Let's see here. I believe I'm going through all this trouble just to check a fan. Honestly, I couldn't tell you what it is. I know what it is. It's a broken fan. Yeah, I barely put any pressure on. The thing is just brittle. I'm still kind of curious though what type of fan it was. A little too brittle for my taste. You even cut me. Wow. Not too sure what they made this one out of, but it is way too brittle. Into the garbage with you. Okay, what we're going to do, since obviously I don't have one, we're going to repack this one, which it actually should last quite a while after you do it. I use a little bearing grease. Get it on your finger. Fill the hole and then push down on it, and what that does is it forces grease to the very end of the race. There, you should never have to grease that again. What's nice about that one is it does have a plug versus a sticker. This is your basically your last resort if you can't have a fan on hand. Pack it full of grease and either clean it up and put the sticker back on so you don't get dust in it. This is old school. This is what we used to do back in the day. And that's it. It's better already. Cool. Direction. I don't remember which way. Oh, it went this way. Yeah, if you start getting a lot of noise in your fan, like if it starts swilling, that's a good indication that it needs to be oiled. There's a number of ways you can do it. There's that way. There's also the way where you can, if it doesn't have a port on it where you can actually oil it, you can drill a little hole and squeeze a little bit of oil in with a syringe. Tons of ways of doing it. But since I don't have any in stock, I have to order one. This will do. Besides, I don't really know, once I get a bunch of hard drives in that tower, I don't know how this power supply is going to handle it. Might end up buying a new one. Like right now, I hooked up a hard drive and a CD-ROM. Pretty much whatever else I can find to power up on it, and it doesn't seem to be squealing or making any weird noises. Let me know it's at its limit. So the thing is, the way I just did that, the longer it runs, the better it'll get. It the oil will work in and clean the bearings and stuff for the sleeve bearing. Dude, this hurts. Man, it doesn't really seem to be much faster. I don't know. It's been like that for a while. Ew, dust. Cool. Well, like I said, next I'll post another video once I get the tower in. Not much more I can do. If I find anything else, I'll do an update. Later, guys.